What you guys, got another video here for you. Now, if you're in the market for one of these Dell Optiplexes or an HP system or something like that, which you can pick up pretty cheap on eBay, Craigslist, or any other site that you may find them on. Now, you'll probably know that there's a lot of YouTubers that create content with these particular types of machines, and I'm going to show you some of the things to look out for before you go out and buy them. Now, a lot of these systems are ex-office PCs, workstations, and they have a lot of pitfalls that you need to know about before you go ahead and buy them. So you can see here, once I've got it opened up, there's a bunch of parts inside, but Dell, HP, Compaq, Fujitsu, all of these brands that have all got these types of small desktop PCs, or maybe you've got the larger desktop PCs, they all come with their own proprietary parts. Now, most of them come with their proprietary parts, which means they can't be easily swapped out. And this is because, like, the power supply will have all their own connectors. Sometimes they're a lot lower wattage, a lot less than the recommended amount that any sort of graphics card company would recommend you use. So you may need to swap those out. Now, the Dell Optiplexes do come in many different types here. You've got the ultra small form factor, and then you've got the desktop DT and MT versions as well. Now, this is a typical motherboard layout for the ultra small form factor. Be very careful, because there's a lot of sellers online that sell these as small form factors, and they're actually ultra small form factor, which limits you even more than the small form factors that you've seen me work on in the past. Now, the reason why they're so difficult to get rid of is because you can't do much with them. There's not a lot of features on there, and also it's crammed tight, and you're very limited to what you can put in, like graphics cards and stuff like that. Now, look at the numbers on the motherboard here, and you'll see all the pitfalls that you need to look out for or think about before you buy something like this, okay? And this will be the same for any of these types of systems, whether it be Dell, Fujitsu, HP, all the systems that you see available on Craigslist and also eBay and places like that. So starting off with number one is the front panel header, which is what's going to go for your new case. Now, you may see that a lot of these eBay sellers online selling cheap gaming PCs, and it's basically the guts of inside of these put into new cases. Now, that being said, that's okay up to a certain degree, but they should be more open about what they're actually doing, because people are actually buying really old parts like generation 1 and generation 2 i5 processors. Now, there is a way to jumper the front panel. You can actually get two wires and jumper the front switch and get it to work that way, because it's got its own proprietary cable that changes from model to model, and you need to be very careful when you're using this. Now, you may have to break away the plastic shroud around the outside and jumper the two pins that actually come to the power switch on the case, which will then allow you to power up the computer itself. Now, that means you're going to lose out on a lot of features like the hard drive activity light, the reset switch, and all that sort of stuff, and it does make it a lot harder to case swap. So if you're looking just to keep the case and you're happy with that, then that's not so much of a bad thing. But let me pick out some of the other faults that you can look out for, which are, say for instance, number two, which are, say for instance, the fan headers. Now, the fan headers are a different pin layout to a standard computer. So basically, when you're looking at these fan headers here and you want to put another fan in the case, you may be thinking, I'll just drop in a couple of new fans with some RGB on it. Well, that's not the case, because these fan ports or fan headers on the board are proprietary to Dell, HP, Fujitsu, and all these other types. But the Dell in particular are proprietary to Dell, and that means the actual cable pin layout is different. Now, that is easy to just quickly switch around and pull them out with a pair of pliers and switch them around. But if you don't know what pin layout is, it can be very dangerous and you've got to be careful. But also, you can buy adapter cables online, but that just keeps adding up and adding up to all the cost of the computer itself, and it can be a bit of a nightmare to get it to work. So all is not golden when you see these channels making these videos on these old systems, and a lot of these eBay sellers that are selling these computers are sort of botched together to get them to work, and you're going to be the poor sucker that buys them thinking you've bought a nice gaming PC when you've bought basically the innards of one of these systems bunged into another case. So be prepared for a bit of a headache if you don't know what you're doing, because a lot of these connectors have got sensors on the board which need to be connected, otherwise you're going to get error codes and error messages. So that makes the board look a bit messy, because you're going to end up with sensors plugged into the board, and there is ways to get around it to trick it, but that's a lot more hard work involved than just building a computer. You've now got to start disabling sensors and things like that and find pin layouts. There's also other things like power connectors for the power supply. These will be very different to normal power supplies. Sometimes you can't even swap out a power supply, and sometimes you can. Some of them have P1, P2 and P3 like the HPs, and some of them don't even have a proper 24 pin layout, and you'll need an adapter cable to try to fix it, or you're going to need to know what pin layouts are for a standard 24 pin and swap those around. This is of course very dangerous, so you need to know what you're doing, otherwise you're going to end up electrocuting yourself or blowing up your system. Now, another thing that you can run into when you're buying these systems is the USB pin layout or the USB layout. It's got its own adapter and it can cause a lot more problems. So Dell have really thought about everything when it comes to building these systems to make it virtually impossible to make it an easy transition across to taking the innards out and putting it into another case. Now, it can be done, but most people, when they do it, will just take it out, put the sensors in, leave them in, and then just basically jumper the start button on the case to get it to boot up, and you'll lose a lot of other features. Another thing, what they've done is the actual pins in the holes. So going back to pin one, or number one, which is the front pin header, is smaller, thinner pins, and they are a lot more smaller. So when you go to put in the case cables for the front panel, which is your power button and your hard drive activity light reset button and stuff like that, when you go to put those cables in, you'll find the metal clips inside are slightly bigger than the ones on Dell, which means now they slide in and out and you don't get a good connection, and sometimes you can run into problems. So Dell and a lot of the other manufacturers have not made it easy for you to do the transition from one of these cases to another case, which means you're now left with the decision whether to use it in its original case, which looks a bit dated, but there is ways of cannibalizing what you've got in that system and putting it into a new case. But it means you're going to need to know what you're doing, and it can be a little bit tricky to get them to work properly. So just bear that in mind. A lot of these sellers will not tell you that it's got the innards from a Dell or HP or any of that. What they do is they take the camera shot from a particular angle and they don't show you inside of the case. They basically just tell you it's got an i5 second gen or first gen or something like that, or an i3 or an i7 or what it is they're selling. But they're very cagey on what they're telling you what's inside there, okay? But they're going to leave it for you to find out when you want to change the heatsink that you're going to run into problems, and when you want to change fans you're going to run into problems and things like that, okay? So bear that in mind before you buy any of this stuff, because it can be very problematic if you're not familiar with this type of problems. So anyway, I just wanted to bring that to your attention. Now, I did make a video the other day about dodgy eBay sellers that are selling gaming or so-called gaming PCs with the innards of all these computers inside them. So be careful and don't get your fingers burned by buying any of those, because they're not worth it. You may as well just go and buy one of these and use it as it is. Now, these can still be used today as they are. As a gaming system, you can upgrade them. There is limitations to the amount of memory that you can put in them, but once you put a bit of memory in it, say minimum of 8 gigs, try and get ones that have got about 8 gigs minimum, and then also have an i5 already in them, and then you can pretty much get as cheap as you can. Don't pay more than, say for instance, 100 or 120 to 130 pounds for an i5 or an i7. because it's not going to be worth it. You may as well build a brand new computer if you're going to do that, because obviously once you start getting to really expensive prices like $300 or $400 for these systems, they're not worth it. You may as well just go and buy brand new and build your own. Okay, anyway, that's about it for this video. It's just a heads up video on things to watch out for with proprietary parts when you're buying either a Dell or HP, Fujitsu, Compact, or whatever it is you're buying, any old server based systems that you'll see with Xeon processors. And just be very careful, do your research, make sure there's room for upgradability in there, and also make sure that you're getting the right kind of deal for the money that you're paying. Okay, other than that, just walk away and ask someone that knows more than what you do about this subject. Anyway, I'm going to wrap this one up. My name has been Brian from brightechcomputers.co.uk. If you want me to buy one of these systems and do a video and show you with a video, then I'll be happy to do that, just so you don't do it. But let me know in the comments section below if you want me to do that, and I'll be quite happy to do that for you and maybe do a transfer to another case for you, so you can see what you're going to have to do if you do buy one of these. Anyway, that's about it. Thanks again for watching. Have a great weekend. Bye for now. Now, if you haven't subscribed yet, hit the big red subscribe button on my YouTube channel and hit the bell notification button next to that to be notified when we upload new videos.